All right, good morning everybody and welcome back to the farm. My name is Bluebelly and this is a restoration project that we're doing with the Agco brand of tractors. There was a barn here. Somebody went bankrupt, basically. And so we are rebuilding the farm. And I have good news and bad news. The good news is that we have seen a little bit of progress overnight. We have this much honey. So 37 liters of honey. So it is working. And I believe we have 457 liters of tomatoes. So we have potential income on its way. And now for the bad news. You guys know where this is going. Look in the top right corner. All right. You see that? See where it says 9541? Overnight, we lost a couple thousand dollars. And now, some of you are very detail-oriented people, and you might be thinking, oh, it wasn't that much. But I actually sold the cows that were a part of the save off screen, so you guys wouldn't have to bear with that process, and we're still this low. So not good at all. What I was thinking we might do today is go ahead and mow some of the grass that we can get to up along the road here. And I was thinking we might test out the Heston baler. I haven't used it yet. And I don't know if we get a, you know, just a grass bale to sell. Or, I don't know. I just want to tinker with... Okay, that's not what I wanted to do. I just want to tinker with that. See, we've got some grass up here as well. So maybe we come up this way also. I don't know. I'm still trying to get my bearings on all of that, but I think we'll go ahead and run along the field here, and that can help us determine where we want to put this upper field, because I was thinking maybe not all the way along the road, but do we want to do this? Let's just go like this. We'll turn it off. See, I'm thinking this little area up here. Like, we've got this driveway. Looks like it was a driveway at some point. I don't know what it went to. Maybe there was another field cut in here. But if we sort of use our landscaping tool and get rid of some of these bushes, we could potentially put, I'm thinking of essentially almost three fields. Let me just show you on the map. It'll be easier to explain what's in my head for you all. So right now we have this, we'll call this the lower field. And I'm thinking, because our main farmyard is here, we could do one giant field here, or we could do like one here and leave this space that maybe could end up becoming like a grass field. And then we could have a smaller crop and then a larger crop here. And then maybe up front we could do a grass field as well. I don't know. It's hard to say what's the best course of action, but I think we're gonna go ahead and cut this grass across the top here and go ahead and see how the Heston baler does for us. We don't have a wind rower, and with only $9,000, I don't think that makes sense. Oh, it doesn't cut the... Interesting. It doesn't cut the sunflowers. I thought it might chop them up. Should I go straight or follow the curve? I feel like the farmer in me wants to just go straight. The gamer in me wants to follow the curve. We'll do another down and back, and then we'll try out the baler. Stop about there. I like this tractor. I like them both for different reasons, but I think this is going to be a fine workhorse for the farm. It's one of the weird things. What? Why did it do that? It's one of the weird things when you start a new save and you're just like coming up with the concept and you haven't really tried the mods. You're just like, let's do this. Let's bring these mods together and do this concept. Then you fire it up and you're like, oh. Like when you don't like a tractor that you're going to have be your main workhorse for a farm, that is a rough feeling. I don't mind this one. I think this is going to be fine. So instead of, you know, on the John Deere farm, we ended up, by the end of it, we had two small tractors, two medium tractors, and one pretty big tractor. This farm, I couldn't even find a small AGCO tractor. Like, I could have gotten an old Alice, or I could have gotten like an old Oliver, which is a precursor to White. But that just doesn't make sense for the storyline, right? This guy didn't go out and buy a bunch of antiques. He went and bought new stuff. He bought new stuff in the 1990s, hence the problem. He spent way more money than he had. I'm also looking at the neighbor's field there thinking, we've got a fancy combine. Maybe what we should be doing with our time, instead of monkeying around with this weed patch, maybe what we should be doing is a contract using our gleaner. Although, fun fact, we don't have a grain trailer. So, GG's on that. Actually, let's just for fun, I know I'm bouncing around a lot this episode, but yeah, see, there's three of these harvesting contracts. Where's field 34? That looks like us. Sorghum for $3,000. Field, what did I say, 34? 31, 30, okay, up there. So we would just take the main road up. Just for the sake of argument, what if I was to look for, I thought I had a Kilbro's gravity wagon in here. All right, maybe we check that out. We could look for a grain truck. But I think our pickup truck with a gravity wagon would be just fine. Well, maybe. Speaking of our truck, we need to take it off the baler so we can test the baler out. I have no idea how big these bales are going to be. If I remember right, Heston bales are like the giant ones, yeah? Oh, look at the jack animation. That's funny. There we go. You have to be patient with that jack animation, my goodness. go ahead and... Boy, that truck sounds throaty for what it is. Interesting. I don't know how well you guys can hear the vehicles, but they sound pretty good to me. The Heston Baylor's from the Mod Hub. Deutz Alice is not. The truck is not, because it's Ford. Oh. So, I'm going to do this real quick. I have no idea how big 181 centimeters is, but I'm thinking that seems... yeah, that's the smallest. We want the smallest because we want to be able to sell as many of these as we can. Alright, let's see how it does. Now, Heston, you might be wondering why I went with Heston. This is actually part of the AGCO brand. Heston Bales, Balers, were purchased by the AGCO brand, I believe, in 93, something like that, 92, 93. So, the fact that he would have bought this brand new with this other new equipment fits our storyline very well. And I confirmed that the Heston 4900s are in the U.S. So, wow, we can go very fast with this. I didn't even hit top speed, I don't think. So we're at 29% of this bale with 1,300 liters. So I'm thinking these are 4,500 liter bales. I know I shouldn't do this until it's already done, but let's look at... Are you kidding me right now? I didn't narrate that very well because I was frustrated. There's no sell point on this map for grass. So we're gonna miss out on about $500 because I can't, well, I shouldn't say I can't, I can try it. But usually it won't kick a bale out, a partial bale like this. So we need to finish making this bale, and then I will TED up what else is here, and the next bale will be TEDed, so it'll be hay. And we can sell the hay. We cannot sell the grass. Oh, that is crazy. What I am glad about is that this baler works great. Tractor doesn't have any issues pulling it, which was another concern that I had about horsepower. So the fact that this is working makes me happy. The fact that we're wasting $500 does not make me happy. But we live and we learn, right? We gotta try stuff to know. I'm also trying to figure out where the pickup is on this left side. Okay, let's go just a little bit. Alright, perfect. Now shut that off. Now we should be able to kick that bale out. Okay, that's cool. Let's take a look at that bale. It weighs 1.3 tons. So we are going to... First of all... screenshot that. And then we're going to put this up on the road. It's weird not having like a clear small tractor, because that's what I would do. You know what? I might as well just run this back. Because we're going to have to get... we're going to have to get the mower to mow more of the grass. Then we'll ted it. Then we'll bale it. Should I cut that tree? I think I'm going to leave it for right now. Eventually, once we get this middle cleared out, we'll be bringing equipment down the middle, I think. Do you know what I mean? That jack animation is trippy. You know what I'm trying to say? Like right now, the lower field is down there. I think it might even make sense to bring the lower field up another, maybe not half, but another third of that width up to like here, like go past this tree, and then have a nice, you know, 15, 20 feet in between, then start this upper field. I don't know. I keep changing my mind. You guys are probably going nuts. Probably like, just play the game. We don't care what you decide, just play. But I bet we could get a bale or two off of this front part too. And, you know, two bales is $1,000. Right? Did I do my mental math right? I think so. That one will probably go. We're gonna cut the existing grass, and then we're gonna paint those things out. Then we can come in and plow in the new field. That's how I see it playing out anyways. There's a little bit down there. I don't know what happens if we mow these flowers. Let's test it just for science. If we mow these flowers, does it turn into grass or is it just... No, it just turns green. All right. Noted. So all those flowers out in the middle we're not gonna be able to make that into hay. So we won't bother with that. That first bale was full length, three swaths. So keep that in mind also. Even if we get two bales off of this and can sell them for $1,000, that's helpful, because it looks like we're gonna have a couple $1,000s cost every month because of this stupid massive loan that it took to get this farm. Can you imagine if this was your real life? I mean, people do this exact kind of thing all the time. They think they can make it. I'll wait until we get a full pallet of honey to go and sell it. That'll be nice. A little bit of cash to be made there. I really wish this would work on these bushes, though. That would make this all a lot better. Because we're probably looking at 500 or 600 worth of bush removal. Which, I mean, that's kind of realistic as well, if you really think about it. Even if it doesn't cost you a ton of money to remove bushes in real life, like it would be time, labor cost. I like that this thing is good on horsepower for this job. I'm gonna back up. I know you're not really supposed to back and mow, and I've done it twice now, but just want to keep moving here. Should I TED with this, or should I TED with the white? I think I'll TED with the white, and I'll bail with this. We're getting to use a lot of our different equipment, though, at least. What is this, the third episode? And we've used both tractors, we've used the mower, we're about to use the tedder, we've used the baler. We haven't used the gleaner combine yet, though. I think I'm gonna load a gravity wagon into the save, and we'll do some harvesting with that. Well, we'll do the we'll do the harvesting with the baler, with the gleaner, and we'll take the truck with the gravity wagon. Let's get this little snippet here. One thing I'm going to try to do with this save, you guys are going to laugh at me that have been watching me for a long time. One thing I'm going to try to do is run, or, you know, go first person from vehicles rather than tab, just because, I don't know, it feels a little more realistic. Not that you would ever sprint like that from tractor to tractor if you're working on a farm. All right, let's test out our new old tedder. Yeah, this snippet up here we should probably do too. We'll have to get to that another time. But the nice thing about this game, you can still make hay pretty late. So does this need to be unfolded? No. All right, here we go. Okay. So it's going about one mower width, and it seems to be leaving about the same. This is a little bit silly that I left that bale there. I don't know what to do with that thing. I guess it'll just be a memento. Unless we end up getting sheep at some point. Which is not outside of the realm of possibility for this save. Like I said, what was it, like 35, 40,000? We're not in a position to buy that right now. But I could see us doing that later. Getting sheep. There's people that raise sheep in Ohio. Ohio's a pretty versatile agricultural state, all things considered. Well, I like it, guys. I like it. It works. not going to save this farm in a, you know, two episodes, three episodes. This is going to be a project. And I like that we're making progress. We're using the resources that we have and the tools that we have at our disposal. This white really hums along. Listen. Sounds good. Sounds a little janky when it starts, but it really starts to whine once it gets going. I like it. I think we're going to have a lot of fun with these tractors, these jobs. So that middle section's kind of wasted, but we'll get going. We're going to be good to go. Tell you what I'm going to do here real quick. I'm going to hop out, and we're going to go like this. We're going to do just some basic grass painting. We'll go V and then a little bit bigger here. So let's watch the money. Okay. So we don't lose money for just removing the weeds like this. So the painting isn't what costs money. It's the planting of new grass. So that, I'm actually okay with that. That's good. So let's go ahead and do some more of this. All right. So we're going to want to get this cleared out. See what I this feels like cheating a little bit, but I just want to show you guys what I mean. Like, if we have this field down here, if we think about maybe like here-ish, put a field in that's about that width coming down here. I don't know. Something like that. And it looks like there was a thing here. You know? Like maybe something was built there, like an outbuilding, a shed of some kind. I don't know. But if we put another field in here that's comparable to that size, then we'll have a little bit of space up here for whatever. Maybe we plant grass. I don't know. We could plant trees, maybe. Drop some trees. There's a lot of options. But I think I'm going to have to end this episode here. We're getting a little long. But you understand. Flowers. How cute. You understand the job that we have set before us. Finish baling, sell the bales, clear more, sell more, clear more, sell more. All right? So, I was going to look at buildings too. Okay, well, we'll talk about that next episode. Thanks so much for watching. My name is Blue Belly. I'll see you in the next. Bye for now.